Hey everyone, Extremis here, and today I'm going to talk about how Activision, by pulling a scumbag move, might actually be a threat to Battlefield 1. This is a quick video that I won't go into too much detail, and it nonetheless exposes their smart yet bitchy business practice. Now, Battlefield 1 releases on October 21st of 2016. Call of Duty Infinite Warfare releases on November 4th of 2016. That's almost a month after Battlefield. Now, at E3, it was announced that players who pre-order Infinite Warfare Deluxe Edition for about like $80, or Legacy Edition, get to play Modern Warfare Remastered a month early. They get to play the campaign a month early. Now, how does this threaten Battlefield 1? Well, let me tell you. Now, a lot of fans of COD hate Infinite Warfare. In fact, I have a video that will be linked in the description that goes further in detail. About why. But the reason most people want to buy it is to get the Modern Warfare. Now, setting the release date a month early for people who buy it not only boosts sales, but possibly steals sales from Battlefield 1. See, Activision knew that once people buy Battlefield 1, the sales of COD will go down, and Battlefield 1 releases a month earlier, which is enough for the fans of COD to go to Battlefield and cost Activision a lot of money. But by putting the release date earlier for the one game that COD fans love, which is Modern Warfare, and setting the price tag at $80, they can actually reach those fans first and possibly keep them in. Now, after spending $80, most fans will not want to buy another game for $60, and Battlefield 1 will lose some sales. Of course, this isn't that big of a deal, but it is a move by Activision that I noticed immediately and just wanted to cover. You heard it here first. I think at least. I haven't checked anyone else's sources and stuff. But yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.